To begin our study of calculus, we should first review the real numbers. When we're children, we learn how to count to 10 because we have 10 fingers, and that's why we use base 10 when we represent numbers. But as we get older, we learn that numbers keep on going indefinitely. So the first set of numbers, 1, 2, 3, and so on, are called the counting numbers, or sometimes they're called the natural numbers. And they get a special symbol, which is what we call blackboard N. If we add 0 to the natural numbers, so the natural numbers plus 0, 0 was a very important discovery in mathematics. We get what's called the whole numbers. And then if we add to the whole numbers the negative of the natural numbers, we get a larger set of numbers, which are called the integers. The integers have a special symbol, which is blackboard Z. Okay, if we take the integers and then allow division by other integers, so we take the integers, which is Z, and then allow division by other integers, which is Z, excluding the 0, because you know we're not allowed to divide by 0, we get what's called the rational numbers. And that has a special symbol, which is called Q, and blackboard Q. The rational numbers are all that engineers need. So when engineers use computers to solve their problems, they use something called double precision numbers. Double precision numbers are all rational numbers. So it's a finite subset of this infinite set of rational numbers. Mathematicians, however, study the whole real number line, so they need what's called irrational numbers. Which are numbers that cannot be represented as an integer divided by an integer. The first irrational number that was discovered was by the Pythagoreans in ancient Greece, and that's the square root of 2. There's a very nice, very old proof that square root of 2 is irrational. Square root of 2 is a solution of a polynomial equation, particularly x squared minus 2 equals 0. So all the solutions of these type of polynomial equations, what we call the roots of polynomials, are called what algebraic numbers. So algebraic numbers are another type of numbers, of which the rational numbers and the integers are members of. These are all the numbers that can be written as the roots of polynomials with integer coefficients. But there are numbers that are harder to represent than algebraic numbers. Those are called transcendental numbers. So these are types of irrational numbers. In calculus, we have two fundamental transcendental numbers. One of them you've seen before from trigonometry, that's pi. Has to do with the circle. The other one that we'll learn in calculus is called Euler's number and has the symbol E. In your mathematics career, it's possible you'll only see two transcendental numbers, pi and E, but it's possible to prove in some fundamental sense that there are many more transcendental numbers than there are algebraic numbers. even though we really don't know many of them. So if we combine both the rational numbers, which are the ratio of integers, plus the irrational numbers, which are the numbers which are not rational, then we get the full set of numbers, which is what we call the real numbers. And the real numbers then have the symbol blackboard R. Okay, so let me review. I first introduced the natural numbers N. Those are the counting numbers. And then the integers, which contain the zero and the negative natural numbers, we call that Z. Then the rational numbers, which are the integers divided by the integers, being careful not to divide by zero, we call that Q. And then all of the numbers, which are the rational and the irrational numbers, and we call that R. R then will form the foundation for our study of calculus. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.